在你看来，实现 The American Dream 美国梦意味着什么？
35%的美国成年人认为是获得了大学学位，40%的人认为是生孩子，66%的人认为是提前退休，而74%的美国成年人认为拥有住房是实现美国梦的关键因素。
Welcome home, guys.
Is this really our house?
Oh my gosh.
但美国房价的持续上涨和市场的火爆，让许多想要购买人生第一套房的美国年轻人面临一房难求的局面。要是你喜欢我们今天的视频，那就记得转发、评论、点赞、关注和打开通知，这样就可以看到更多我们 Plus 房精彩内容耶。
过去两年，房地产市场如火如荼，需求急剧增加，
导致房价攀升。自新冠肺炎疫情爆发以来，房价已经上涨了约34%，这使得一些年轻的美国人很难实现拥有住房的美国梦。
Because every old person in a city like LA or New York or London is the same. They're like, my house is worth $2 million, but when I bought it in 1981, I paid 11 raspberries for it. And every young person's like, I have 9 roommates.
房价上涨并不是美国年轻人面临的唯一难题。让我们来看看究竟还有哪些原因让美国年轻人买房变得如此复杂。为了获取真实的首信息，我们联系了我老家的一位房地产经纪人。
My name is Sam Heine. I'm a realtor here in the Louisville, Kentucky area, and I work with family realty.
第一个难题，库存不足。
Sam强调了一个主要的问题是，全国各地都缺少空房。
Well, that's sort of been the big story here, is there's more buyers than sellers in the market. Here in Louisville, it's no exception.
正如经典的商业法则，供求决定定价。还有些其他因素也在加剧市场竞争。
There's not enough houses on the market to meet the demand of the folks that want to buy houses. I think that's impacted a lot by a big wave of investors that are coming through and snatching up a lot of inventory, different houses that they're going to rent out on their own. There's people that are buying 4 to 5 rental properties that they hold on to.
这是一些美国投资者用来增加财富的一种方式。他们不是专注于股市，而是专注于购买房产。但影响购房的不仅仅是单人投资者。
But then there's also these hedge funds, these big conglomerates that pool investor money and are able to come into different markets around the country and snatch up, you know, single family houses and a lot of multifamily houses with cash and close quick. They have buying power because they have this pool of money.
而很多时候，房屋被这些团体购买后，可能会在相当长的一段时间内不会在市面上再次出售。
That's also where a lot of the inventory goes as well, because when they snatch that inventory up, you know, it's not coming back. They're holding it as rentals, rental properties, and they might own it for, you know, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years before that inventory ever hits the market again.
美国年轻人在财务方面面临的其他问题也使高房价变得更加复杂。
助学贷款债务和被压抑的工资。
巨额学生贷款债务是美国年轻人购买第一套房的另一个关键因素。
全国各地持续上涨的高房租以及不断膨胀的学生贷款利息，可能会让人很难存下钱买第一套房子。
除此之外，经济大衰退后工资受到抑制，以及来自年龄较大、地位更好的买家竞争，让买房变得更难。
第三个难题，加息。
最近旨在控制通胀的利息上调，也影响了购房者和市场。
The interest rates are tough. That's a hurdle as well, because that costs money too. You know, like in January this year, you could have bought a house with a 3.25% interest rate, maybe a little bit lower, and now we're looking at like 5.25 up to 5.75.
这就意味着你可能要每个月多付几百美元的房贷。这会让你每月的开支更高，生活的压力变得更大。
But you know, obviously you're building equity. It's for a greater good of being able to pull the equity out of that in the long run, but it makes it a little bit tougher in the short term.
但即使美国年轻人面临如此激烈的竞争和困难，买房还是有很多好处的，而且有一些帮助年轻人买房的政策。
Federal programs, there's FHA loans that you could pre-qualify for, that also have, I think 3.5% is the current minimum that you have to put down on something like that.
Sam 说，这些项目给首次购房者提供了很多机会，因为在目前的市场上，他们不需要存20%的首付。尽管困难重重，但在展望未来的时候，买房仍然会带来很多好处。
Don't let this market discourage you. Don't read too much into the headlines. I've helped so many first-time homebuyers get into houses, and you might have to put in 5 offers or 10 offers before you get one accepted, but just keep going and you'll be glad that you did because you own that house, you'll be proud of that house, and ultimately over time, you're going to build equity in that house. It really gives you a great head start on your future endeavors.
感谢你收看我们今天的视频。在你居住的城市，年轻人买房的市场是怎么样的？可以在评论里和我们分享。Yeah.